I think it's absolutely necessary that also the German government has to take up their responsibility, as they have agreed in the coalition agreement on the future of Europe, that Germany has to spend more towards the European Union, that Germany has the responsibility that we get our own fiscal capacity, that the multi-annual financial framework will be handled under the German presidency. This has to become a success. If this will be a failure, I think Europe will be at risk, and this is not good for German citizens, as not good for French citizens.
Ludovic Subran, your reaction to that, perhaps as a Frenchman working in Germany, do you think Germany is ready to really take European solidarity seriously in the sense of putting its money on it?
Yeah, I think so. But as an economist, I'm always looking at, you know, what's happening underneath. And the issue is, of course, that you still have voices against the European Central Bank and the low or negative interest rates, because Germany's savers feel that they're being taxed. The issue is that the business community fears for future corporate tax increases. And so, of course, everything that is spent now is seen as a debt to the future. This is still very much what the German business community is looking at. But I believe that Germany is coming out very strong from this crisis in the way it is committing itself to its own to its neighbors, to its outlets. Germany is taking a form of leadership that is economic, but that is also in terms of policies. You know, in France, we adopted Kurzarbeit, the furlough, from Germany because we know it worked in 2008, 2009 to safeguard jobs. How, you know, much more cooperative can we be than this, right? But the future is, of course, about, you know, making sure that, you mentioned this fear that is very present in France, that France is lagging behind, that the French manufacturing sector will never be stronger, you know, than the, you know, its neighbors, and that we see Germany putting a lot of money, and in France, you know, because of the past money spent, we cannot do as much. So that's going to be, of course, something that leaders, federations like Herr Hoffmann's Federation, and, you know, the unions will have to discuss and to reassure one another, to show how it is important, how important it is that supply chains work together instead of trying to see this cannibalistic Europe. We need to go from rules to trust. We need to go from safety net to springboard. We need to go from, you know, a real cooperation. That means that, yeah, maybe reshoring will mean that we will have more workers in one country than another. But in the end, it will mean more workers in both countries. And this is something that we really need to start explaining now to avoid that 2 years down the road, we have another Greek moment. For me, that's the biggest fear I have. And I want to avoid that at all costs by explaining really what we're doing right now and what should happen.